The Old Testament records that God's chosen people, Israel, were instructed to place the blood of a sacrificial lamb on their door frames. Doing so diverted the angel of death from their homes. This first Passover ultimately led Israel from Egyptian captivity to freedom.
This pathway to freedom was really a foretelling of the Creator's plan with the Holy Lamb of God, Jesus the Christ, who would eventually come to free all people with the blood and sacrifice of his own life.
It is this Lamb, the perfect and living Lamb of God, we gather to worship this hour. He invites us to come just as we are, to remember and gratefully acknowledge him as the road to our own spiritual freedom.
Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Extraordinary love of God revealed in the life and death of Jesus. Our Lord's earthly journey was a reflection of God's relentless quest to invite his greatest creation, the human race, into a personal relationship with himself.
Jesus, the living sacrifice of God, offered compassion, mercy, and forgiveness to those who embraced him and received his gift of salvation. And to those who received him, he offered even more, life eternal with God himself.
What wondrous love is this that caused the Lord of bliss to bear the dreadful curse for my soul?
Israel were gathering in Jerusalem to commemorate, as they had for centuries, their deliverance from Egyptian bondage. It was just days before the Passover feast, and the crowd was growing in anticipation of this grand celebration.
But there was an additional dimension of excitement because Jesus, the one many proclaimed to be the long-awaited Messiah, was among those arriving in Jerusalem for the Passover.
As he arrived, throngs of people surrounded him with shouts of Hosanna, blessed he is who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the King of Israel.
Yeah.
after his triumphal entry into Jerusalem, Jesus directed his disciples to a home where he would share the Passover feast with them. It was in this setting that the teacher further revealed God's master plan, a plan that would ultimately lead to the sacrifice of his own life.
As they met in this quiet and intimate place, Jesus broke bread and shared the cup, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, broken for you. Take and drink. This is my blood, which is poured out for many. Do this in remembrance of me."
Jesus, the high priest of heaven, who freely offered forgiveness of sin, was soon to become the sacrificial lamb of God.
Following the Passover meal, Jesus and his disciples went to a place called Gethsemane to pray. After a while, an angry crowd led by Judas, one of the disciples, arrived to abduct the master. Jesus was taken away to be presented to the Jewish religious leaders, where he was falsely accused and ultimately sentenced to die.
On this night, the prophetic words of Isaiah, written centuries before Jesus walked the earth, were fulfilled. He was oppressed and afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. He was led like a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before her shearers was silent, so he did not open his mouth. Surely he took up our infirmities and carried our sorrows. He was pierced for our transgressions, crushed for our iniquities. Punished that brought us peace was upon him, and by his wounds we are healed.
The holy, spotless Lamb of God was sentenced and nailed to a cross to die a criminal's death.
In the last hours of his life, he completed the mission to which he had been called, to take upon himself the sins of the world as the pure and sacrificial Lamb of God.
Hanging between two criminals, one on his left and one on his right, Jesus prayed that God would forgive those that had rejected and sentenced him to death, the very people he had come to save. Father, forgive them, for they not know what they are doing.
As Jesus gazed upon his captors, gasping for his final breath, even then he embraced his murderers as he sought forgiveness on their behalf.
Kyrie eleison, Lord have mercy. Truth, this man was the Son of God.
Thank you.
Now it was dawn on the first day of the week. Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to look in the tomb where Jesus had been buried following the crucifixion.
As they arrived, an angel appeared to them and said, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are seeking Jesus, who was crucified. He is not here, for he has risen, just as he said. Go quickly, tell his disciples, Jesus has risen from the dead." They hurried away from the tomb, afraid, yet fulfilled with joy at the news. Jesus was alive.
We join the people of faith who down through the centuries have celebrated the good news that Jesus, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, lives and reigns eternally.
Crown him with many crowns, the eternal, living Lamb of God, who reigns upon his throne forevermore. It was the Passover lamb which helped the chosen people of God to be released from Egyptian captivity.
It was the sacrificial lamb who bore our sins on a cross and gave his life for our release from spiritual bondage.
And it is the resurrected living Lamb who invites us into an eternal relationship with the God of the universe to live and worship forevermore.
Near the cross, O Lamb of God, bring its scenes before me. Help me to walk from day to day with its shadow o'er me.
Worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and wealth and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and praise.
This is Edna Johnson, the St. Matthew Sanctuary Choir. Our musicians, would you stand? Ms. Joanna, Alfred, Gerald, our other musicians. Mrs. Gwen Poole, our Daystar dancers. Jason McMaster.